an easy way to think about it is if your normal day consists of swimming 100 miles in the ocean, and now you're swimming 75 feet, and that's your entire existence, is just so unnatural an environment. You can dress it up, you can make it look blue and ocean-like, but it's a fact of being a social, roaming animal, and then constrained within basically a bathtub. And so I think it's psychological, physiological, impact, really.
Everyone wants to know if using an animatronic dolphin is different than using a real dolphin. The difference is you don't have to do animal husbandry. You don't have to have breeding programs. You don't have to worry about the safety with human beings. And you can use your imaginations to imagine entirely different kinds of educational and entertainment experiences for the animals to do. It doesn't just have to be about acrobatics. The marine park industry has been kind of consecutively losing money decade by decade for the last several decades for a lot of reasons. There's a way to reimagine it. We've been seeing acrobatic shows for almost half a century now. Imagine what would happen if animals that could never be in large aquariums came there. Great white sharks, fantasy dragons that could come out of the water and spit fire. Jurassic animals that you could swim with and experience that world. It's not only about dolphins, it's also about anything your imagination can come up with.